students, in this lecture we will learn that why compounding is done, is performed with a steam turbine. Okay, many times it becomes difficult that why compounding is done. Compounding is also known as staging of steam turbines. I will try to explain you clearly that why the compounding is done. Okay. Now, there are two types of turbine, one single stage turbine and the other multi-stage turbine. Single stage turbine is the one in which there is a nozzle ring. You can see over here, there are a number of nozzles implanted over this ring. Okay, and there is a moving blade ring. Okay, this is the moving blade ring. So what happens? Steam enters this nozzle coming from the boiler. Okay, and expands in the nozzle. So it becomes high kinetic energy steam. It glides through the blades and in turn pushes the blade in tangential direction, and blades are connected to this shaft. So when the blade moves, the shaft rotates. Remember, the nozzle ring is connected to the casing, is fixed with the casing of the steam turbine, but these moving blades are connected to the shaft of the steam turbine. Okay, so this is a single stage turbine. Why? Remember that one set of nozzle and one set of moving blade makes a stage of a steam turbine. Okay, here there is one set of nozzle and one set of moving blade. Okay, so it is one stage, single stage turbine. Through this all nozzles, the steam is going inside with high velocity coming out and gliding over this inner surface of the blade, and in turn the blades are pushed and in turn the shaft rotates and power is developed. Okay, now this is the case of a multi-stage turbine. Okay, in multi-stage turbine what happens, there is a set of nozzle, you can see this is the first set of nozzle, then there are moving blades, then there are guide blades, then there are moving blades, then guide blades, then moving blades. Okay, so one nozzle ring and one blade ring comprises of a stage, then this is guide blade ring and this moving blade, this also comprises a stage, then again guide blades ring and this moving blade ring, this also comprises of a stage. Okay, so what happens, see that the steam coming out from the nozzle, okay, hits the first blade ring, okay, by one nozzle. Okay, steam is coming out from this particular nozzle. So by example, I am telling you, steam hits this blade, so blade is pushed in tangential direction. Then when steam is leaving this blade, it is again turned back. You can see it is turning back by the help of these guide blade. Okay, this is a guide blade ring, and again these guide blades are fixed, they doesn't move, and this ring is actually fixed with the casing of the turbine. Moving blade rings are connected to this shaft. Okay, so the push on the moving blade ultimately turns this shaft, but this guide blade rings are connected to the casing. So you can see that hitting this first blade ring, then again when it is coming out, then it is again turned to hit the second blade ring, again turn to third blade ring, like so on. So over here I am showing you three stage turbine. Three, why is three? Because one set of nozzle and associated one set of moving blade comprises a stage. Similarly, one set of guide blades and one set of moving blade also compose one stage. Okay, so this is one stage, the first nozzle set, then the moving blade, first stage, then second guide blade set and moving blade, second stage, third guide blade set and moving blade, that is third stage, like this. So in this picture I have shown you the three stage turbine. So multi-stage means, as compared to that of only single stage, okay, the steam is passed through number of blade rings by guiding them. Okay, by the help of guide blades, the steam is guided to strike with the other set of blade, like this. Okay, here I already shown you, coming, hitting, turn, hitting, turn, hitting, and ultimately comes out. Now, what is the purpose of this compounding? The question is this. Okay, I am telling you the answer. See, suppose there is a single stage turbine. Okay, single stage turbine. Then steam comes out from the nozzle ultimately, just be attentive to this arrow, steam comes out from the nozzle ultimately hits the blade and heat is pushed in tangential direction. Okay, now what happens, that I am not showing you the derivation, I am just telling you what the context is. Over here I have shown you the magnified view. Suppose I say that the steam is coming out from this nozzle with velocity c1, okay, and blade is moving in tangential direction, so this line represents the tangential direction. Okay, this steam makes some angle with that tangent. Okay, suppose that angle is alpha 1. Okay, so ultimately steam goes, strikes the blade, ultimately glides and go away. So the tangential velocity of blade is given by u. Okay, now the question is, what is the value of u for which we will get maximum work? Understood my question? That steam is coming out from the nozzle with velocity c1, making angle alpha 1 with the tangential direction. It is gliding through the blade and blade is moving with velocity u. So what is the value of u at which we will get maximum work? The answer is, I am not deriving over here, the optimum u is equals to c1 cos alpha 1 by 2. Okay, this formula tells that in case we want maximum work from the blade, then the U must be equals to C1 cos alpha 1 by. In case the blade is not moving with this velocity, either higher or lower, we will get lesser amount of work done like this. Now suppose I say that this angle alpha 1 is 20 degree and the velocity of steam coming out from the nozzle is 1200 meter per second. So with this much velocity the steam is coming and alpha 1 is 20 degree. Okay, in that case, if I am putting these values in this formula, what I am getting, that optimum U is 1127 meter per second. Okay, so for getting maximum work for this input, okay, the blade velocity must be 1127 meter per second. Okay, so in case the rotor diameter, okay, I am taking the rotor diameter D and I am taking it as 1 meter. Can you tell with how much RPM the shaft will start rotate? In case U, the tangential velocity of this rotor is 1127 meter per second, okay, and the diameter of this rotor is 1 meter. In that case, what will be the RPM of the shaft? It can be found like this. So this much amount of distance the blade will cover in 1 second, that is 1127 meter. So in case I am dividing this distance with the circumference of this rotor, okay, this blade ring, what I will get, how many number of circumferences it will cover in 1 second. Okay, so it will give me the rotation per second, U by pi D. Pi D is the circumference. In case I am multiplying it with 60, I will get the RPM. Okay, so by putting this value of U and value of D, that is 1 meter, I am getting 21,535 rotation per minute. Okay, you know, many times this much high RPM is not required. For example, suppose this turbine is developing power to feed in a electrical generator set. Okay, and the generator set is developing alternating current with frequency 50 hertz. In that case, the shaft of generator set must rotate with 3000 RPM. Okay, understood? Means requirement of RPM is less and the RPM developed is very, very high. So understood this concept or not? It is very simple to understand that if we want maximum work, then the U, the blade velocity must be equal to this. I took some values, alpha 1 equals to 20 degree, C1 equals to this much, then U must be this. In case the diameter of this rotor is 1 meter, then this much RPM we are getting. We want reduced RPM. Now what is the problem? The problem is that without losing power, RPM is to be controlled. That's it. Okay, I told you some data, I am getting this much RPM. So in case I want to reduce the RPM and I want same power, okay, so what to do for that? There are solution. Increase the rotor diameter. Okay, since diameter is in the denominator, so in case I am doubling the diameter, I will get half the RPM. In case I am quadrupling the diameter, I will get 1/4 of this RPM. But doubling diameter will give what? Greater diameter of this wheel, greater mass, greater moment of inertia. Okay, so that will lead to what? The dynamic control of this wheel will be difficult. That is, in case sudden acceleration of the wheel is required or sudden retardation of the wheel is required. Okay, so the real time control of the wheel will become sturdy or difficult in case moment of inertia of the wheel increases. So increasing the rotor diameter is not a better option. Now using a gearbox, ultimately by gear sets, okay, I can lower the speed down. But we know this thing that gearbox has its own efficiency. It can kill 20 to 30% power. Okay, these values, I am telling typical values, it could be lesser or higher. But gearbox can kill 20 to 30% power. Okay, and remember, in case the turbine is developing the power in megawatts, then 20 to 30% is a very big thing. Therefore, that is also not a good option. Okay, do not run blade with optimum speed. Again, there is a problem. In case we are not running the blade, the tangential velocity of blade is lesser than this value. In that case, what will happen? The maximum work will not be obtained. What will happen? We will lose work. So now the fourth, which option is actually practice in this case, is the multi-staging of turbine. This is what the purpose of multi-staging. Okay, we don't want to increase the rotor diameter. We don't want to use gearbox also. Okay, and we also do not want to move the blade with optimum velocity. Then the best option to obtain same amount of power, okay, with lower RPM. What we want? Ultimately, we want the same amount of power with lower RPM. Here, same amount of power is with high RPM, same amount of power with lower RPM, that we want. So this option is a viable and suitable option, multi-staging. Now, how multi-staging is performed? See, first of all, I will tell you that what is velocity compounding, okay? Multi-staging or compounding, same thing. Remember this thing. Either I say multi-staging or compounding. So what is velocity compounding? What happens? that you can see that this is our steam turbine. Okay, you can see first set of nozzle, then moving blade, then guide blade, then again these yellow colored pictures are for moving blades, and these are the guide blades, moving blade, guide blades. Okay, steam is coming out. I am taking a particular nozzle, coming out from this nozzle, striking the blades, then coming out again, turned back by the help of these guide blades, again hitting these second set, coming out, turned back, again hitting, and then coming out. Okay, and I already told you the guide blade rings are connected to the stationary casing. So these are stationary, only these moving blades are in moving condition. Okay. Now you can see that there is a graph. Okay, and you can see set of nozzle I have shown by this dashed line. Okay, this set of moving blade, dashed line, again guide blades, dashed line like this. I think you would have understood now. What happens, this x axis is telling the point of steam in this passage. Okay, these are actually stages. Okay, so in stage where it is like this, and this y axis is telling that what is the velocity and pressure of steam. Okay, this red line represents the pressure of steam. You can see red line. Okay, and this blue line represents the velocity of steam. Now what is velocity compounding? In velocity compounding, what happens, this is the first set of nozzle. Okay, what happens in nozzle, all in all the pressure drops. You can see pressure is dropping, this red line is shifting like this along the length of nozzle. Okay, and pressure is dropped, and on the behalf of that the kinetic energy increases. You can see this blue line is showing that how initially the steam is entering with almost zero kinetic energy and ultimately shooting up. Okay, with maximum kinetic energy it is coming out from the first set of nozzle. Okay, how this happens, because in the first set of nozzle the pressure drops to its minimum. Okay, now when steam is at this point, okay, suppose the energy content of steam at this point is 100 joules. Okay, so when it will pass through these moving blades, okay, then suppose I say only a portion of energy is absorbed by the moving. In case it would have been with single stage, then suppose 100 joule is the kinetic energy, it could have been absorbed 80 joules. But here suppose I say only 25 joules of energy is absorbed. Okay, so what happens if moving blade is absorbing only partial amount of kinetic energy of steam, in that case it will run with slower speed. Okay, means here the blade is not moving with optimum speed, as I shown you with this formula. Blade is not moving with this speed, blade is moving with slower speed. So in case it is moving with slower speed, suppose due to this thing the blade is moving with 50 meter per second. Okay, so only 25 is absorbed, so it will come out with 75 joules of energy. Now this is the guide blade set. Okay, guide blade ring. So what will happen when the steam will pass through these guide blade rings, then the steam will be guided, will be turned to hit the another set of moving blade of this second stage. Okay, this is the first stage and this is the second stage. Okay, so when the steam will pass through the guide blades, there will be no change in kinetic energy or velocity. Reason being that guide blade's job is just to turn the steam, that doesn't absorb any energy. It is same as suppose I am throwing a ball over a vertical wall. Okay, and I am not considering any sort of friction. So if I am throwing with 5 meter per second with the same velocity, it will bounce back. Same thing, the when steam will glide through these guide blades, no change in kinetic energy or velocity will take place. Okay, so here 100 joule, 25 joule is absorbed, then 75 is left, so it is coming with 75 joules. Then again suppose 25 joules are more absorbed in this second moving blade ring. Okay, so again if only a portion is used here in the first stage, by absorption of 25 joules of energy the blade velocity is 50 meter per second. Again if there will be only 25 joules of energy absorbed, these blades will also move with 25 meter per second. Then again there is one more set of guide blade. Okay, no change in kinetic energy, then again 25 joules. Okay, so again in case only 25 joules are absorbed, so again these blades will also move with 50 meter per second. Now what is happening, all these blades have tangential velocity to be 50 meter per second. Okay, so in case all are moving with same velocity, and ultimately entire power is used. Okay, 50 meter per second, 50 meter per second, so they are connected to this rotor, so with slower speed the entire kinetic energy is used. Okay, you can see ultimately steam is coming out with minimum kinetic energy. Okay, by using the kinetic energy in parts. Okay, this is what called as velocity compounding, because with slower velocity of blades ultimately we are using the entire, almost entire energy of steam, as compared to that of in single stage, in which only one moving blade set is there and obligatory we have to move it with optimum speed and we obtain high RPM, that's it. So this is what your velocity compounding. Okay, the main thing in this regards is that the Kinetic energy of steam is developed only in the first nozzle ring. Okay, this is the first nozzle ring. So here the entire pressure is dropped and full conversion of kinetic energy takes place. And later on in the stages, there is no any change in pressure. You can see pressure becomes constant. Only kinetic energy used partially with first set, with second set, and with third set. With lower velocity of blades, almost entire energy of steam is used. Okay. Now what is pressure compounding? In pressure compounding, it happens like this. In pressure compounding, the guide blades acts as a nozzle. Okay. The job of guide blades are not only to redirect the steam, but also to expand the steam inside. Means guide blades are solving two purpose. One, turning the steam. Okay. Other, expanding the steam also. How I am telling you? Suppose I say that steam is entering inside with this much pressure. This red line is pressure line and blue line is velocity line. Okay. So what happens in the first set of nozzle, only small portion of pressure is dropped. Okay, here full drop of pressure in velocity compounding, but here a small portion of pressure is dropped, so a small rise in kinetic energy. Okay, suppose I say here when entire pressure is dropped, the steam is coming out with 100 joules. Okay, but here suppose pressure drop is not full, you can see partial pressure drop, so steam's kinetic energy is already 25 joules. Okay, that 25 joules will be used with this set. So entire 25 joules, almost entire 25 joules is used. However, entire absorption is not possible. But here, for example, I'm telling that only 25 joules of kinetic energy is developed. So in case 25 joules are used with this moving blade, automatically it will move with lower speed. Then what happens? These are the guide blades, first set of guide blades. Okay, you can see these two lines between these guide blade falls. So these guide blades are also acting as a nozzle, means the designing of these guide blades are as such that steam can expand through it, same as like that of nozzle. Okay, so what happens in the guide blades, some more pressure is dropped, again kinetic energy increase. If pressure is dropping, so kinetic energy is increase. Suppose this increment is 25 joules. Okay, then when they will hit this moving blade ring, entire 25 joules are used. Okay, now what happens when coming out once more, you can see the guide blade of this third stage, again some portion of pressure is dropped, again kinetic energy increase in the guide blades. Okay, then again 25 joules of kinetic energy is available over the exit of this guide blade ring, again it is used and ultimately coming out. So in this case what happens, that pressure is dropped in fragments. Okay, in velocity compounding, that pressure is dropped only in the first nozzle ring and velocity is used in fragments. Okay, with the example I told you, 100 joules is the kinetic energy over here, only 25 joules is used, so blade speed is slower. Okay, here what is happening, pressure is dropped only to that much extent so that 25 joules of kinetic energy only developed. Okay, in case steam will enter with only 25 joules of kinetic energy, the blade speed will be slower, then it will come out with almost zero energy, again pressure dropped in the guide blade, again kinetic energy increased, suppose it is again 25 joules, since only 25 joules of kinetic energy is available with this blade set also, so it will also move with slower speed like this. So what we see, that entire pressure is dropped in the case of pressure compounding in number of stages. So hope with this lecture you would have understood that what is compounding, why it is performed, and what is the difference between velocity compounding and pressure compounding. Thank you.